Wastafel is a bit deeper. Sometimes you can put soup. Sometimes usually orang yang put people put pasta. Okay.
This is this one.
Soup cup.
This is a soup cup. As you can see, what makes it a soup cup is it has 2 ears. Okay. Like mug, but 2 ears. Okay. And this one usually comes together with a saucer. And you have to make sure it fits together because it will first it's easy to carry because logically speaking as a server, you will not hold the dish because it's hot. So they can have like a cold pump. So this is much more stable. Much more stable and much more better and easy to carry. Saucer also depends on sizes. There are bigger and smaller. Depending if you want to put a cup of drink or whatever, it's different. Okay, this is a sundae bowl. You put ice cream inside it. So I think you guys know this one. This is a cocoa ice cream. So this is all right. Okay, this is a cereal bowl. Cereal bowl, as you can see. We are going to shape you like this. This means a cereal bowl.
Hey, what you please have you? Oh, I am please.
Everyone has their own cutlery. Normal cutlery sendiri kan, memang has different design. But most of it you can apply that particular list at home. Macam mana kita rumah kan? Contoh, disciplinary. Itu semua dah tak jadi buah yang diberikan kat kitchen kan? Rumah buat tak?
Sometimes
jarak selalu. So, masih ingat lagi ke challenge? Ya. Ya, saya ingat lebih kurang macam Alhamdulillah. Kalau yang macam kekot lagi tu, maksudnya still kurang practice. Same, here as well. From the house, as you own challenges, in kitchen, same as well. Right? Those who are in the culinary, of course, you expect that when you are in the kitchen, that you can do it, that when you are beloved, you know how to do all the kitchen process. Same goes to the hospitality student, and the front of the house, this is where you should be for the strength. Okay? Yang mengajar dia dapat info, yang belajar dia dapat info, yang mengajar dia kena fikir macam mana kasi orang ingat benda ni. Whether it is funny, serious, sarcastic, dan sebagainya. Right? So now you kawan kata, ni tengok jenis besar foto. Right? Ada masalah, kita ada. So my way is very simple. Come here kakak. Gila. So, very simple, apa nama ni? Three. No, this two. Bukan dua ni. You two different hand. Bayangkan, dekat atas sudut tu ada makanan. Kosong mula. Masa tu lah. Okay. Yang itu kosong mula. Kalau itu kosong mula, kau bukit tak? Kenapa tak okey? Why not? Masuk lah. So, kelakar kan? Tambah akar kan? So, simple. Yang besar-besar bukan tak buat. Kerja bukan untuk customer. It is for the waiter to do the service. So, you go to this one as well. Okay? So, every perspective baik from the left, starting from appetizer. So,
dessert.
So, here you only do 4 course. Some place, they do sometimes up to 3 course, 5 until 20 course. Okay? So, the price is very expensive in the place. So, begin with the setting set back again. Starting with the appetizer. Typical, nothing so much of different. So, we move forward. After the appetizer, slope to spoon, round shape, slightly curved. A normal spoon but around shape. This is for you to scoop the liquid and sit in your mouth. Right? Very straightforward. 99% they know what is this. Okay? Kenapa saya kata ini yang sebelum? Kenapa saya kata ini bukan customer?
Besar
kan? Kenapa saya only student untuk sebelum dia? Sebab setiap anak yang bersilap. Saya tengok sini. Okay? By the way, soup ladle ataupun sauce ladle or gravy ladle. And after that, this main course cutlery. Begin with table 9, table 4. The difference is one small and one big. One short and one tall. Okay? If you ask me what is this, then I just say it's a knife. It's obviously. If you show me multiple, then I can give you the answer. You just slap on the table or any flat surface, then you can see the difference of the size. Okay? So, standard table cutlery. If the menu has pasta or rice, add on tablespoon, besar sikit. Okay? Then you have fish cutlery for main course, specific for fish item. Okay? So the difference between these two fork, the table fork and fish fork, both for main course, but the shape slightly is more curved, like here. Okay? Boleh. Okay? Cuma sikit. Right? Fish fork. Nothing much of a difference, just it acts sebagai simbol perbezaan saja. And this is a fish knife. Kenapa dia panggil fish knife? Kenapa? Macam mana?
Tak sakit.
Dia tak ajar.
Sebab ikan lemon.
So ini steak knife. Dia tajam. For you to cut your meat at term. Okay. Specifically that. No stick eh. Stick keluar tu. Saucer. This saucer, all of this small plate we call as a saucer. act as an analyzer for the coffee cup, soup cup, cereal bowl, so on and so forth. The difference is the function for each bowl, each cup or bowl. Okay? So for this one, it's also for soup cup. Sebab dia ada tiga, kiri kanan. And this one, basically, traditionally, is going to be piping hot. Hot. F hot. Okay? Because most of the chef or the cook, they pour the sauce, soup in this bowl, and store it in the oven to keep it warm. When I say warm, 80 degrees above. And at that temperature, even at that temperature, normal people, whether you have 10 years or 2 months experience in F&B, you only ready to roll it for less than 2 seconds. 1, 2, then you can hold it, you need to hold at the saucer. Momo in transfer from the plate to the table is around, I think, 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 seconds. Then when you walk, sometimes the times need to add on. Okay? Then the coffee cup. Same. Don't touch because it's for the customer to sip the drink. Okay? Do not touch the ring, the pin. Otherwise, you can see no finger way. And you don't really want to drink it. Right? And this one here. This is actually another one here. Saucer for cereal bowl. The saucer is almost the same. The shape is the same size as this one. But it has two rings. One, the first one, the second one, and the middle. Allowing for the actual shape at the bottom to be placed on the saucer. Okay? Some soup cup also can put. But some, most of it cannot because the small rim and the bottom of this soup cup is the same diameter. So you cannot put. Otherwise, you will jiggle around. Okay? But can you mix and match all the saucer? Yes, you can. Unless it is not relevant. Okay? Sometimes if you want to put the cereal bowl on this saucer, yes you can. But it's very difficult. Advisable, you put some small paper at the bottom. Dolly paper, for example. Apa ni?
Bagi tak bergerak.
Haa, korang akan gerakkan dolly paper. Alright? Apa ni?
Sama kan?
Sama. Okay. So, saya tukar kena buat atau ada. Kalau ada atau ada, make the jingle. The jingle lah. Make the jingle atau ada. Make a picture for the coffee machine, right? But in this situation, you have to use the machine, you use this for something else, for time making. This one, what do you call this? Jug in bahasa umum, bahasa rumah. Okay, jug. Sebenarnya bukan apa?
Jug.
So we call this water pitcher. Water pitcher, bukan you pitch for the baseball tu. Right? When you pour it, you can pour it like this. You can pour it like this. You can pour it like this. But don't ever pour like this. You don't put the finger inside. Otherwise, it will be dirty. Water plate, sauce cup, but simply dinner plate. Or some place call it show plate. Or you can call it just a show plate for the set, the VIP table. The shape, the diameter can be very long, sometimes up to 40 cm. But the numbers, you don't need to know. As long as it is big, it is small, then it is for dinner plate, for show plate. To hold, again, very easy, multi-purpose, you can do depending on your capability. And it does it only like this, like a frame, it's a frame. So you get the back, this 3 finger, and 2 finger for and both hands, at the front, pop and pop. If you have a very strong hand, or slightly strong, then your this finger akan dilebak. So, baik sikit lah. And person like me, tak boleh. Tak cukup kuat. Boleh cukup?
Contoh
je, jangan.
Tak, ambil korang buat.
Ha? Saya lah orang tu yang buat. Dia bucat. Apa dia?
Dia buat sharing dengan.
Ha?
Tak sampai jadi korang buat.
Saya kata dia sendiri.
Saya lah orang yang boleh
ke tak? Boleh kalau dia mampu. That's why you need to practice after this. Okay? This plate, I not advise you to carry more than two. At least two. Okay. But for appetizer, for any small plate, at least
three.
Okay? So, one, tak nak ambil sikit, bahaya. Okay, this is weight, some people call it, but not me. My way is the two finger at the back. Okay, one finger on the top, and the other two finger, two on it. Then you carry, another plate. Then you carry, another plate. Oh! Okay, jalan je. Okay, dia jalan. Kena bersandung lah. Bersandung memang bye-bye. And, when you carry this, depending on how the chef plate the food. Sometimes the plate can be very stable. Sometimes, let me think, sometimes they pour so much sauce. And they can buat seni. Padahal dia di atas. Tapi awak tambah-tambah satu ini yang premium. Kan? Tak nak gitu. Okay? So, if you cannot carry three plates, then two plates is enough. Ah, ini apa? This plate has no ring. Zero ring. Nah lah. Okay, dari plan seperti muka baby. Habis. Apa namanya?
Baby plate
pada barang. Okay? Baby plate pada mata plate.
Korban.
Okay, ini?
Kok?
Apa dia?
Kok?
Jangan cakap cucu.
Kok?
Siapa cakap? Dia cakap tu. Dia cakap tu. Tak baik tu.
Dia cakap separuh. Decanter.
Decanter for coffee and tea. Right? Cafe 6 rand. 40 ringgit satu biji ni. Ini saja kopi ringgit. Ini warmer dia. Okay?
1 biji?
Alhamdulillah. And last, this is your wine bucket and wine stand. Okay, ini apa dek?
Wine stand.
Maksudnya apa dek? Itu apa sih dek? Okay. And bawah ini?
Jet stand.
If you ever to buzzing the plate, do it. If not ever do it. Jangan buat. Some people do it for banking purpose only. Dan ini panggil? Bandai. So next, we're going to move on the table setting, very basic. Okay, so we take a few moments break. Now it's 9:50.
So as you can see, the reason why we put the water here is because when the server wants to do a high heat, it's much more easier instead of tak macam ni, takut langgar. So kita macam ni. Dan lagi satu, kita kena take as a common sense space. Like this meja kita set seorang je, but what if kita nak set? So kita kena tengok space juga lah. Kalau macam terlalu ni, dia pakai sikit ke ataupun jangan ada space ni.
Okay, so what have you shown by your friend is that basically what he said using common sense, the settings pun ni betul. Alright, just a matter lah sebab limit masa. Pada peti pun, awak pun semua sebuah kelas, saya sah pikap dalam setting ni. Alright? So, ke sini kekurangan, okay, siapa yang datang minggu lepas? Okay, datang minggu lepas kan? Kurang dari setting ni. Di depan tu bukanlah masing-masing kewajipan. Depending on setting. Kalau normal people, no need to input. Okay, but for VIP, we can put for lagi. Right? But the rest is all the finesse. So, to make the job more easy, the first thing to do is to send is to apa nama ni? Kain, tablecloth, lipat. After lipat, you need to fold seperti yang tunjuk dekat awak tadi. So you bring the cloth to the respective table and begin to display for all the table. So dia punya floor plan tu kena betul dululah, right? So then you lay. After you lay, the first thing that you need to put is the table centerpiece dulu. Because that is the starting point where you can set the rest of the setting. Where you know where is the center for the table. Senang nak tahu lah. Let's say kalau only one or two person responsible in setting the table, so mata dia akan berbinar. So we need to know the technique. Okay. Awak pun sendiri tahu kan macam mana nak make sure komputer awak laju, macam nak pastikan baju awak bersih semua tu kan. Same goes to the setting as well. Okay. So mesti set dengan tengah-tengah dulu. Alright. Letaklah dengan apa cara sekalipun nampak tengah-tengah. then you can set the rest. Maybe you can start with, saya ketepikan dulu, we set with the design gallery. So this is the center point here. Then you can rearrange the setting. The left side is betul, appetizer and dinner fork. The apa nama ni, baby plate is towards, same with baby knife, is towards the left side here. Belah kanan ni tak ada masalah. Cuma dia kena kasi rapat sikit, tu je. So basically, from my physical hand, around satu jengkal setengah gitu. Kenapa saya kata gitu? Easy for, so that I can know the same length for this plate. So bila saya letak, sedap-sedap lah. Apa langgang macam tu. But that is very exciting to some people. Okay, so bila letak tu, kita pun buat the final adjustment. By the way, this setting is need to be done after you wipe. Biasanya macam mana awak saya tadi, dia pegang macam ni. Kan? So jangan, bila you kasi ni, apa akan berlaku? Macam mana kalau ada fingerprint? Tengok macam ni. Tengok kepada lampu. Okay, kadang-kadang nampaklah muka, nampaklah hidung seperti dalam ni. Kadang-kadang nampak kesan lipstick lagi. Okay, pegang dekat stem dia sahaja atau dekat neck dia. Okay, for the glass, for the cutlery, hold at the neck or at the stem. Okay, ke bawah ni. If you need to hold it like this after you wipe, yes you can. You need to invest another around 2 to 3 ringgit, beli gloves. Cotton gloves, to be specific. Okay, otherwise you need to hold it like this. Macam pegang, okay. The rest of the setting betul, starting from appetizer, soup and main course. This setting is considered as a universal setting. Kenapa? Semua orang akan nampak seperti ini. But when it comes to the menu, some of it need to change. Let's say your menu ada nasi atau pasta. So what you need to add on?
Spoon.
Tablespoon. Okay, so ambil gap, put tablespoon. Can you set tablespoon immediately? Boleh ke tidak?
Tak. Boleh.
Boleh.
Some kata boleh, some kata tidak. Kenapa awak kata boleh? Ui, jujur je.
Dah kalau dia nak guna, so dah ada lah.
Let's say in the menu, ada nasi atau starch atau pasta, you put tablespoon. You kata boleh. Kenapa?
Dah ada kat menu.
Apa? Yes, sebab dah ada kat menu. Dua-dua benda tu senang, jawab, letak je. Tapi sama orang tak nak letak, kenapa?
Tadi dia kata tidak.
Okay, so dia kata tidak, ada yang kata tidak. Kenapa? Kenapa dia kata tidak?
Because sometimes during the course baru dia nak bagi the sword.
Bila kenapa dia letak?
Oh, tak letak siap-siap.
Confusing kot.
Not confusing. Semak.
Yes. Ambil space.
Okay. Ambil space. So boleh awak decide tak nak letak dulu. Sometimes in my defense saya tanya, kenapa tak letak? Pada saya tahu jawapan dia, saya ingin jawapan dia dulu. Jawapan orang jadi RMA. Kalau tak jawab, dia salah lah. Dan itulah saya akan kerja dengan dia. Okay. So let's say, kalau nak menu awak tu dua-dua ada nasi atau pasta, boleh tak siap? Kalau tak nak letak juga sebab semak, tak apa. After soup, before serving course, then you need to correct the cutlery. Okay? Ini baru tak flower vase lah. Sorry, centerpiece. Centerpiece, table number. Okay? So,
okay,
pun yang penting.
Sudah buat. Wash hand lah.
You want
to use hand?
So, bila customer dah makan, you tanya dia. Mister, miss, you can do it. May I clean this place? Kita okay, kita clean kan. Kadang customer dia pergi signal. Kalau dia dia macam ni, maksudnya dia rasmut, berehat. Dia akan sama semula makan. Kalau dia buat macam ni, 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, sama ada gerak macam ni ke atau macam ni, tak masalah. Dia dah makan, jadi for the next meal. Kalau dia buat macam ni, kalau dia buat cross, nungguin tu, maksudnya dah sedap.
Oh.
Tapi makan habis. So apa jawapan dia?
Ada
feedback. Basically, a feedback or indicator yeah, whether the food is not nice, tak suka makanan, something wrong, ataupun service tak bagus. Okay. Tapi dia habis sebab apa? Menghormati orang keliling dia. Okay. So clear play dia pula. Ada caranya, if you have a wrist table, you can just lay it on your leg, place it on your left hand. Tapi dia boleh bergerak, biasa kita. So what you can do, to place the fork in between, knife in between the fork, and angkat it terus. So stable lah dia. Okay, kurang gerakkan dia. Okay, place your right hand, left hand, then push the strap towards the end of the plate. Then we proceed with the next customer. Angkat. Push crack ni ke pinggir ini. Tapi jangan halik ke muka customer. Pergi ke belakang dia. Okay. And then proceed to the next plate tak atas ni. Sampai you bawa macam ni jalannya. Bawa-bawa and then bawa ke kitchen. Then after that, satu sudu ataupun gelas pakai tray juga. Okay. And you need to hold like this. Ya, yeah, betul, tangan saya besar, badan saya besar. Tapi kita hanya pegang tray ini hanya dengan tapak tangan saja. Okey. Sebab ramai orang nampak saya pegang macam ni. Ada saya support. Saya bukan, saya pegang macam ni tangan dia. Sebab ramai saudara semalam nampak saya pegang macam ni. Sebab tangan saya besar. Okey. Terus pergi ke sini je. And the surface of this tray is tidak apa nama? Tidak licin. Dia akan ada diserah sikit. So dia stable. Okay. Stable sikit lah. Okay. Sebab kalau you jalan-jalan, pop sikit. Dia dah pun jiggle. Kalau dah jiggle tu, I know. Lagi. Okay. Tunjuk lagi, tunjuk. Okay. Oh, sorry. Dia stable lah. Tu je saya jawab. Okay. Kalau you angkat gelas pun, dia sebenarnya stable. Always position your item at the pump, at the center, then towards your elbow. First glass, second glass. Selebihnya left and right, depending on the your you stabilize, step your you stable. Okay, buat gini, relax je bawa. Then you pergi. Yes, bila yang kadang bila jalan tu rasa macam unstable sikit, but that's normal. Okay, that's life. That's okay. Life is unfair. Okay, so untuk sup ni, you rasa macam ni, senang je, tak jatuh sendiri. Then you need to hold the saucer only. Then bagi kat dia. Make sure tak kiri dah kena tinggalnya. Dia kalau dia berada di posisi lain, just pegang saucer dia, dia pusing slowly. Jangan pusing sini pula. Okay, then go counterclockwise and with last customer. Then biar dia makan. From time to time, make sure the water glass, the water goblet need to be filled with water. Okay, biar dia makan. Bila dia makan, kumpang, dia dah dimakan. Atau dia bagi signal, tak macam ni. Okay, then go kita angkat. Tapi nanya dulu lah. Baik clear, berulang-ulang, dia kisah clear.
Thank you.
Macam ni je. Dan keluarkan. Dan for the last customer, kita angkat sebelum ni and moving on. Proceed with our main course. Sometimes pick up based on your preference before you give them the main course. Then you give as usual. After you give, allow them to eat, ambil distance. Every course, bagi mereka distance untuk bagi dia orang makan. Jangan pergi dekat, tengok dia makan. Lebih-lebih lagi kalau badan yang macam ini, besar-besar ni, kiki besar, akan nampak mulut bergerak. Sebab apa tahu? Sedap tu dia makan. So, jangan buat begitu. Take distance, ambil jarak, biar dia makan, biar dia enjoy dulu. Kita buat kerja kita dulu. Dan from time to time, tanya dia. Semisa, how was your main course? Yes. Is everything okay? Yes. Will you require some extra sauce?
Yes.
So, kalau you nak, kita ambil ikan, kita tuangkan. So, extra sauce, most of the time, kita apa-apa kita nak. Bila ada alas, then you can tuang. Okay. Tray, here, kalau tak nak tray, makin ikut, boleh pakai alas ni jadi.
Sekali boleh, sekali boleh. Kadang-kadang, two customer, two different cost, two source. So, pakai the plate. Okay. Satu je, buat sini je. Semua ni pakai common sense. Would you like me to pour the sauce on top or side?
Side or top, bapa?
Bapa macam ni. When they say top, meaning on top of the protein. Side, serap protein lah.
On the top of the protein, please.
Please stop me, sir. Lagi?
Stop, cakap stop. Kalau
nak. Kalau tak kena stop, dia tuang sama habis. Okay? Bukan. Bukan dia akal. Dia tuang, is it enough, sir? Kalau tak cakap lagi, dia tuang sama habis. Okay?
Okay.
Nice goal. Semua jawab, dia tuang. Sometimes, bila awak dah penat, mulut tersasul, so sebelum tersasul, tarik nafas, fikir pada cakap. Berhasil, saya dah kena dah. Malu saya. Tuang. Okay? Sebab apa tau? Saya malu. Sebab customer tu
perempuan.
Saya demonstration, saya buat demonstration tu pun chef student perempuan. Lelaki yang sekarang tapi dia yang kena. Malu. Saya malu, dia pun malu. Good. For example, customer ni makan rekaan kat tangan. Kita beri dia lagi, so kita clearkan. Okay? Motor dah habis, kita clearkan juga. Air ini biarkan, still kena refill. Okay? Boleh, minta orang assist. Okay? Then we clear. Okay. So, on the pressure curve, also clear. Sebab masuk akal ke kau pakai rizet pakai salt pepper? Takkan. So, kita clear kan lah. Okay.
Real
tea, please. No more. You want to drink? Jangan buat orang buruk pula. Would you prefer some coffee, tea, or me? Oh, orang buat. Tu boleh lawan-lawan lama lah. Okay? Jangan buat orang buruk itu. Kalau nak buat sangat, aku akan kasi try. Tersambung macam semalam. So, kita bagi dia cawan kosong dulu. And we give them on the right side of your guest. Okay. Facing 4 o'clock and 5 o'clock. 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock. Kenapa? Kalau saya buat begini, macam mana nak minum? Cuba pegang. Tengok, belajar dia pun tak habis lagi, bukan cara pun tak erti. Padahal dia boleh, dia pusing macam ni. So, kalau macam ni pula, macam mana caranya? Tengok, bodoh sangat. Dia dah minum. Kan? So, lepas tu dia letak sini. 4 o'clock and 5 o'clock. So, dia pegang macam mana? Alhamdulillah, tangan tak krem. Okay. You baca dalam ni, buat angkat macam ni je. Sebab bawah ni panas, letak atas tray, rosak nanti tray tu. Ini mix, tuang cover. Kenapa?
Steam.
Percik tu bukan, steam tu ya. Percik tu sebenarnya pun ambil dah. Okay, tak nak kena meja, tak nak kena muka customer, nanti jatuh make up dengan inci dia. Okay, dia pun nak pakai ikan. Sekarang ni pakai. Ataupun terbalik. Dan jadi baik. Kan? Dia tuang. Jangan tuang banyak. Separuh je. Sebab dia dah makan banyak. Lepas dia sampai dessert banyak tu. Kenyang. Okay? Kau sikit. Kalau dia dah lebih, kosong tu. So, kita juga nak dia sikit. But, when you say the customer request on some coffee, cup, some tea, kita buat apa?
Dan coffee?
Buat apa? Putih? Kita bawa sesuatu dulu. Okay? Sebab bahaya. Kalau banquet, dia boleh buat masuk banyak sebab cepat. Tapi ini fine dining tak boleh buat satu. Or you can ask someone to assist you to pour for the next customer. Tuan tuan sini. Tuan tuan sini. Okay? Then we go over.
Creamer,
please. Please stop me, miss. Sama juga macam sauce tadi. Tuan.
Stop. Cepat-cepat
dia.
Ada yang pergi pelik buat macam ni. Cik pusing. Cik tak tahu berapa.
Tweet sir.
Tweet sir.